At Uberpad, our customers regularly ask us to explain the difference between digital coaxial and digital optical audio cables. There are also a few people who think both these technologies are the same and they use the terms interchangeably. So, we decided to bring you this quick primer on these truly useful technologies. Before we get into the comparison, please subscribe to our channel. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified every time we post a new video. Now that you've done that, let's dig in. For more than a decade now, both digital coaxial and digital optical technologies have shared the responsibility of carrying and transmitting digital audio signals in high resolution between playback sources such as CD, BluRay, DVD and other media players to amplifiers, receivers and other sound systems. However, they are fundamentally different in terms of the connector types, cables and resolution support. Let's move to their comparison, competencies and drawbacks. Optical or TOS link, as it is also called, uses the medium of light to transmit data through the cable's optical fibers, which is usually made from plastic, glass or silica. It usually sports a thinner cable and is terminated with a unique squarish connector. It is easily identifiable thanks to the light the connector emits. Coaxial digital, on the other hand, uses electricity to transmit audio using multi-core wires and is terminated with a RCA connector. Don't be tempted to use a standard RCA phono cable in place of a dedicated coaxial digital cable. They look similar and may even work in limited capacity, but you may experience some quality loss. TOS link is capable of handling a bandwidth of up to 48-bit 96 kHz. On the other hand, coaxial digital is capable of handling a bandwidth of up to 24-bit 192 kHz, making it a clear leader in terms of resolution. Optical is usually found in most modern flat TVs, DVD and Blu-ray players, sound bars, AV receivers and integrated amplifiers. On the other hand, coaxial digital is usually found in legacy devices such as older DVD or Blu-ray players, DACs, FM tuners and stereo amplifiers etc. And its popularity is steadily declining. TOS link is immune to DAC circuit noise, ground loops and RF interference. However, the fiber core of TOS link cables is delicate and needs to be handled carefully, especially around tight bends and corners. You can ensure to have enough strain relief to avoid damages. On the other side of things, as a coaxial cable transmits signal using electricity via metal-based wires and connectors, it is more prone to picking up electrical noise and hums through the signal path. Even the strength of the signal decreases, especially in longer cable runs. So, ensure to use higher quality branded variants and keep the cable run to a minimum. Both coaxial and optical cables support compressed Dolby Digital and DTS surround sound only. As both these technologies are decades old, they don't have the bandwidth for lossless audio formats. Needless to say, they also miss out on newer surround sound formats such as Dolby Atmos and DTS:X, etc. Both coaxial and optical technologies are a great way to transmit high resolution audio. So, what you choose for your setup ultimately depends on the devices you are trying to connect and the trade-offs you are ready to make. That being said, at Uberpad, we would recommend HDMI for interfacing. It is a one-size-fits-all connection for both video and audio. It brags of much higher bandwidth than optical and coaxial, allowing for playback of lossless audio formats such as Dolby True HD and DTS HD Master Audio. HDMI is also a constantly evolving standard. Its new and improved versions offer more bandwidth and greater capacity to carry more channels of audio, such as Dolby Atmos and DTS:X soundtracks. It also supports new and current video formats such as Ultra HD 4K resolution and the various HDR formats, and additional features such as high frame rate, ARC and the latest EARC, which can deliver up to 32 channels of audio. If you want to learn more about the different types of AV connectors quickly, we recommend you check out our two-part video on the same. It is linked in the description. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, subscribe to our channel and follow us on social media for more such interesting and informational videos. Thank you for watching.